Welcome to the first episode of New York Real Fit.
Today's the day, and oh my goodness, besides getting ready is to hydrate yourself with enough time before so that you don't get cramps. I do very casual exercise, and I don't really push myself that much. I jog with Izzy, and that's it, so you get ready. So I'll see you there.
Like, what are you talking
about?
Keo!
Hi.
How are you?
I just stepped on shit.
You what?
Last time I rode a bike was on a stationary bike in Bushwick. I had an injury, knee injury last year, so I'm slowly getting back into it, and that was really hard.
Last time I rode a bike, I was hired to be a bike messenger for a film. They thought I was a real bike messenger when I got to set, and they didn't tell me what I was gonna do or anything. I wasn't really prepared. All they said is, can you ride a bike? I was like, yeah, the casting people, that is. And when I got there, I realized that I was supposed to get on a bike with a bike messenger bag and chase after a car swerving in and out. It was insane, and I actually couldn't do it. Like, I had charlie horses on my legs, and they had to replace me. Or rather, they didn't replace me at all. They just stopped filming eventually and got some crew to do it. Pretty horrible.
Last time I rode a bike was last night at the Velodrome in Queens at a race. And I got first in one of the races and second overall because I lost to a 14-year-old.
The last time I rode a bike was at a spin class. I do spinning a lot, so I'm very curious to see how this will be different than the other spin classes I take.
The last time I rode a bike was riding over here to meet up with the crew today.
Race last night, and Adam rode in here.
Cyclist.
You do look like a cyclist, according to the casting.
Right, at the time.
Welcome to IMAXShift.
Thank you so much. Because we have to remember that once we're out, we are sweaty.
Woo! You get ready.
Yes. My outfit, let's do it.
Yeah.
And he was telling us you have like a neon thing.
Yep. So we have a Beyonce ride. Our first edition of it was last night. Sold out. It was amazing. So a mix of her music videos and all of her songs. And then we're doing it again this Friday night at 6:30 and Saturday. Because like girls love Beyonce. The people want
like
it.
Like the whole it's hour. It's just Beyonce.
It's just Beyonce. Well, it's 45 minutes.
Right.
Yeah. I want a Madonna.
Yeah, me too.
We're taking requests. We want to do more themes.
Yeah.
We're doing a Governor's Ball theme ride next weekend
cool.
as well.
Yeah.
Having people in front next to me and behind me was really helpful.
Yeah.
Normally, I would have stopped.
Right. Well, the thing is, there's no mirror.
Right.
So you're not looking at yourself, which is great because you're not focused on you, but at the same time, you're feeding off the energy of the other people in the room. We want to make sure that it's really accessible for someone who's ridden a million times is going to have a really hard ride, and someone who's never been here before is going to feel comfortable, so that it's really inclusive.
Yeah.
Actually, I feel like I stopped wearing makeup since I started working out more.
That's what I did. It's just not worth it. It's a waste.
Maybe a little bit of mascara, but
the foundation all melts off.
We try to match all the choreography that we do with the visuals so that it feels connected. You know, you feel like you're climbing a hill, you feel like you're speeding through the forest or the ocean or whatever it is.
But I'm like, can I ever go to an IMAX again and not have a bike there?
I don't know.
Bring your bike into the movie theater.
Yeah.
Carl, what do you think?
I definitely got my ass kicked.
Carl was ready.
You called Carl.
Because I set him up, so I So he was like, I've never done anything like this before. I'm like, I'm gonna take care of you, but of course I extra push him. Anytime I know your name, I'm gonna extra kick the director
that tried to make you chase a car. He'd be like, I'm ready now.
I wasn't ready.
I can totally play this like badass bike part now.
Emma, these four biking experts who bike here.
You bike outside. Yeah.
I never managed to make it to outer space on my like.
Yeah.
I might fix your bike. It just doesn't go that far.
Any of the scenes where there's like a roadway and you're like anticipate the hill coming up, that was kind of cool. That got me definitely motivated.
Yeah.
What are the other exercises you like doing?
Well, I really love cross training with boot camp classes. Two of the other teachers here who are master instructors, Jesse Alexander and Marie Brinker, both teach different boot camps. So when we do a lot of cardio like this, it's really important to weight train as well. Otherwise, you're kind of just burning a lot of calories, but you're not building muscle.
I got an idea. You should get scenes from tons of movies where there's running in it. Play those scenes and be like, you gotta, you know, complete this mission or whatever they're running at.
Mission Impossible.
Yeah, Mission Impossible stuff. Tom Cruise loves to run. Run, run, run.
Just running. You're running the entire time.
So I'm here with Bryan. Bryan, thank you so much.
Thank you for coming.
For this IMAX Shift experience. This is my first time. I'm not very familiar with cycling.
Yeah.
And I had a knee injury last year, but I got through it and I tried a third. What do you call that?
The third position.
Okay.
We got you to do a tap back.
Yes.
What does that mean?
You know, when you tap,
yeah.
You tap
back. Yeah.
Well, you're supposed to hold the middle or the side.
That's right. The sides.
The sides. I'm just following everyone else.
Well, that's the beauty of group cycling is that you're getting the energy of everyone else in the room.
Absolutely.
And then we're able to bring like the energy of that IMAX screen too.
Right.
So you've got like something to look at. And you're also having the choreography and the great workout.
And the energy of the instructor.
That's
she was
right.
awesome. She had a lot of energy.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes, for sure.
Well, so what'd you think?
I loved it. Like I said, the space part was really profound for me to like travel through space. It's so cool. And then there's like the Tron.
Yeah.
Things you were going through tunnels. That was really cool. Like video game.
We're trying to find the right mix of how you create an immersive experience for the rider, but also keep it like fitness forward.
Exactly.
So you get like a fantastic workout.
Yeah.
But you're also not thinking like, wow, this is a workout I'm doing, right? You want it to be challenging but fun.
Absolutely. And it was great to be distracted also
because
you at times I was so focused on the video I wasn't even paying attention when I was really exercising hard.
People walk out of that room and they're like, they're drenched in sweat.
Yeah.
So you go, okay, the workout, check.
Absolutely.
Check out the workout, and then you always say, like, did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah.
You know?
How did you become interested in creating a space like this?
Yeah, it's, you know, I think when you look at, like, boutique fitness,
right
everyone's sort of going to that world, they're saying, big box gym, yeah. not that interesting. I want to have this personal experience. I want to have this engaging, big experience.
Right.
And when I hear you, when you think about that big part, I go, this is an IMAX world.
Yeah.
Like, what IMAX does really well is it takes experiences that are kind of pedestrian
yes.
and amplifies them.
That's true.
And so it's sort of like, you look at fitness, and people are putting screens on a bike. People right. are starting to get that point of view cycling footage.
Exactly, right.
It's not that compelling on wow. a little screen or a little projector.
Right.
You bring the IMAX sound into it. You bring the IMAX size into yeah. it. And all of a sudden, it's like, this is something completely different.
Yeah.
And then we're trying to kind of create that newness, uniqueness in the market for folks. Right.
Totally. And I was saying, like, now I feel like if I go to a regular IMAX afternoon, I'm going to
That's, don't tell the folks who are corporate, but our, right. my goal is for people to say, don't bring the popcorn here. I go, no, bring your
IMAX.
And there's something very powerful about using visual stimulation and visual imagery to
yeah.
take people somewhere transportative.
Right.
Like we like to say our kind of mindset is, transport your mind and transform your body.
Right.
So you're empowering people to think like, what else?
Yeah.
And not think,
my legs hurt.
That's right.
Yeah. Totally. No, I really felt transformed. And also there was an emotional connection that I don't know that I would get in other kinds of workouts.
Yeah, yeah.
Which was really interesting and intriguing.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Oh, like, there are some songs that I liked and I was like, oh, that's my song. And then I was like, push extra hard.
Yeah. We hired the best instructors.
Absolutely.
We've unleashed them creatively on that music.
Right.
But then we've given them this IMAX sound system that no one else has.
Yeah.
Hopefully you felt it, right?
Oh,
like
yeah,
when
sure.
the bass comes in, it's
yeah.
it's a little bit different. You can literally feel
DJ.
That.
Yeah, I'm a DJ.
Oh, okay.
Musician as well.
Oh, awesome.
So, yeah.
Very nice. What kind of music?
Pop and dance.
Okay.
It's similar to some of the
yeah, yeah, yeah.
yeah.
What kind of a rig do you? What do you roll
with? It depends on the situation, but it's like CDJs or computer.
Yeah. So. I used to DJ back in the
really?
Day, but I was records. Like, I got crates of vinyl at my parents' house still, and they're like, what are you doing with the vinyl records?
Yeah.
But I have, I always ask because I have those old Yamaha, towers,
yeah.
The 2,000-watt system. Like, wow. Yeah, it's fun. But if you DJ, you should drop some mix off. We'll play them in the
cool.
Yeah. The lobby if you
awesome.
Want. That'd be fun if you did this kind of music.
Yeah,
we're
totally.
Happy to drop some stuff off.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
Come to ride again, though.
Yes, sure. Totally, I will.
Like my first song ever taken.
Oh, God.
Look at the size of these lockers. It fit my whole tripod in there. Dry shampoo, and it's the first time I see dry conditioner. I've never used it. I also have never seen face wash in any studio.
Sweet too.